Here comes Brown, number 48.
Shot and a save. Rebound and they score!
Number 19, Logan Ehrlich.
He shoots it on Larrick. He shoots. And he scores! It looked like Huffman was there for the rebound.
They are now back in it. And here comes Stanley. He's making his move around.
He shoots it. He scores!
It's a hockey game now, folks.
The Washington Lee Generals enter 2015-16 optimistic, coming off four winning seasons in their last 5 years. With only one senior returning, forward Cole Praver, 15 others gained valuable experience from the previous campaign. At the core of the team was a talented and reliable junior class led by captains Ben Stanley, Peter Harvey, and Spencer Brown. Fellow juniors Sarah Brown, Francis Penny, and Carlos Wilson were also back, along with standout goalie Carson Chirka. Returning with them was a battle-tested group of sophomores, including defenseman Jeffrey Henderson, Will Schmidt, and Connor McCormick, with forwards Ned Huffman, John Petrich, Kayla Ehrlich, and Theo Vargas. They were joined by six freshmen. Scrappy forwards Max Lustig, Andrew Robinson, and Jacek Zavora provided additional depth up front, while shifty newcomer Logan Ehrlich had the makings of a future star. Jack Stanley gave the club another talented and physical defenseman, while Matthew McKnight, an athletic goaltender, gave the Generals another solid option in net. I'm NCAA hockey announcer Neil Sika, and I'm back again to share with you the 2015-16 season of your Washington Lee Generals. In the season opener, Washington Lee welcomed George Mason Edison to the CSHL with a 7-0 steamrolling. WL's top line of Ben Stanley, Ned Huffman, and Francis Penny combined for 6 goals to lead the offense, while defensemen Peter Harvey, Will Schmidt, Jeffrey Henderson, Spencer Brown, and Connor McCormick suffocated a would-be attack. Goalie Carson Chirkup stopped all 16 shots en route to the shutout, and Theo Vargas rounded out the scoring as the Generals picked up the opening day victory. The Generals then traveled to Prince William to face off against Robinson High School. The Generals took advantage of a couple early power plays. Goals by Spencer Brown, John Petrich, and Logan Ehrlich gave WL a 3-1 lead after one. Ehrlich and Petrich each added another tally, and senior forward Cole Praver scored his first goal of the season. Freshman goalie Matthew McKnight, making his WL debut, was strong. He stopped 15 of 17 shots as the Generals won comfortably 6-2. The following week, WL handed defending CSHL champion West Potomac their first loss of the season, ending the Wolverines' 10-game unbeaten streak dating back to last year. West Potomac jumped out to a 2-0 lead midway through the game, but Carson Chirkop made several big saves to keep WL in it. Freshman Max Lustig scored his first high school hockey goal in the period, giving WL some momentum as the game entered the third. With under 9 minutes to go, Ben Stanley evened the game when he rocketed a slap shot over the shoulder of the Wolverines' netminder. Seconds later, Ned Huffman scored to give WL their first lead, and then just over a minute later, Huffman scored again to stun the defending champs. West Potomac would cut WL's lead to 1 with 5 minutes left, but the Generals quelled West Potomac's frantic push over the final minutes with stout defense and strong goaltending. Ned Huffman's empty net goal in the final seconds completed the hat trick and added an exclamation point to WL's dramatic come-from-behind victory. Off to a 3-0 start, next for WL was the talented and deep Hayfield Hawks. Energized students from both schools filled the rink, creating a playoff-like atmosphere in just the fourth game of the year. Midway through the first, Will Schmidt's slap shot from the point got the Generals on the board. In the second period, Hayfield tied the game on a breakaway goal, but the Generals responded strong, scoring 2 goals before the end of the period. A 4-straight victory in sight, Hayfield battled back, scoring 2 goals in the final 6 minutes. It was an intense 45 minutes of action, the game ending in a 3-3 tie. The Generals hosted West Springfield in the club's last game before the holiday break. The teams traded 2 goals apiece of the opening period, before WL blew the doors open with three goals in the second and three more in the third en route to a rout, 8-2. Spencer Brown's move from defense to forward helped spark the offense as he and his linemate Logan Ehrlich recorded two goals. Ben Stanley and Ned Huffman also added two goals apiece, and freshman Jack Stanley had three assists. Matthew McKnight made 16 saves for the Generals, who improved their record to 4-0-1. Returning from the winter break, the Generals picked up right where they left off, soundly defeating George Mason Edison for the second time. 5-0 the final in this one. Matthew McKnight stopped all 12 shots he faced, while five different Generals tallied. Ben Stanley and Max Lustig each had goals in the first period. In the second period, Cole Praver's one-timer from the right side extended the lead to 3. A few minutes later, a beautiful tic-tac-toe play executed by Logan Ehrlich, Jack Stanley, and finished by Spencer Brown added another. In the third, Stanley's blistering slap shot past the opposing goalie rounded out the scoring. Washington Lee continued their unbeaten streak with a 6-4 victory over divisional opponent W.T. Woodson. Ben Stanley and John Petrich scored to give the Generals a 2-goal lead after the first period. But the Cavaliers battled back with two quick goals early in the second. The teams traded goals as Petrich and Stanley each scored again for WL. But the Generals were able to pull away down the stretch with goals from Logan Ehrlich and Cole Praver. Plus, strong defense and goaltending led to a 6-0-1 start with Carson Chirkop making 37 saves. W.T. Woodson didn't have to wait long to get another crack at the Generals. The two teams faced off a week later in the second game of a home-and-home series, this time on the Cavaliers' ice at the Mount Vernon Rec Center in front of an inspired crowd celebrating senior night. Fueled by the atmosphere, the Cavs came out strong and jumped out to an early 1-0 lead. Woodson's senior goalie had a game to remember as he made numerous spectacular saves throughout the night, frustrating the Generals. Early in the third period, Ned Huffman's breakaway goal tied the game at 1. It appeared WL had finally broken through, but Woodson countered with two quick goals. An empty net goal, the icing on the cake, as the Cavs, led by their seniors, handed the Generals their first loss of the season. A week later, WL was back visiting Mount Vernon Rec Center, this time against a hungry West Potomac team, out to avenge their lone loss to the Generals earlier in the year. The Wolverines came out fast and furious, peppering Carson Chirkop with a barrage of shots. Chirkop did his part to keep the Wolverines scoreless, but West Potomac broke through with two late goals in the first period. Another goal early in the second expanded West Potomac's lead. Two more goals in the final minute of the second put the game out of reach as Washington Lee had lost their second in a row, being shut out 5-0. The schedule didn't get any easier as WL traveled to Prince William to play South Division leader Forest Park Hilton in the final game of the CSHL season. Despite being drastically outshot, the Generals hung tough through the first period, giving up just one goal. After Forest Park Hilton scored two goals early in the second, the Generals responded with a quick goal when Ned Huffman took a pass from Theo Vargas and raced through the defense and ripped his shot over the shoulder of the goalie. However, just as WL was gaining momentum, a series of questionable calls from the refs led to Will Schmidt, Ben Stanley, and Spencer Brown being stuck in the sin bin for most of the second. Forest Park Hilton took advantage of the situation, stretching their lead by several goals, winning comfortably 7-1. Despite the three-game losing streak, Washington Lee finished the regular season as the number 2 team in the North Division. In the first round of the playoffs, they were paired against number 3 seed from the South, West Springfield. While WL was unable to capitalize on a few early scoring chances, they did a great job of limiting West Springfield's scoring chances at the other end of the ice. The tight game turned into a defensive struggle and eventually entered the third period scoreless. The Generals finally broke through with a goal early in the third by Ben Stanley. Several minutes later, Will Schmidt scored to give WL some insurance. At the other end of the ice, Matthew McKnight and the WL defense held strong in the final minutes to complete the shutout, winning 2-0 to advance to the CSHL Final Four. In those semifinals, WL faced South Division champion Forest Park Hilton once again, who had beaten the Generals by 6 just a couple of games earlier. After a tornado warning delayed the game by 40 minutes, the puck finally dropped. WL came out energized and went toe-to-toe with their talented and deep opposition, resulting in a scoreless first period. It appeared that a perfect storm was brewing for an upset after Forest Park had a goal disallowed, followed by a Generals power play that resulted in Ned Huffman banging in a rebound to put WL up 1-0. However, Forest Park responded quickly to tie the game, and the teams entered the final period deadlocked at 1. With 58 seconds remaining and the game still tied, the teams lined up for a neutral zone faceoff. After the Generals gained possession of the puck and chipped it into the offensive zone, Forest Park countered by sending that puck bouncing up the ice into the neutral zone. Ben Stanley and a Forest Park player raced toward it for possession, but it took a fortuitous bounce and helped turn into a 3-on-1 for Forest Park. Forest Park executed a beautiful pass and one-timer, finding the game-winning goal with only 31 seconds left, handing the Generals a heartbreaking loss in the conference semifinals, eliminating them from the playoffs. With the CSHL season done, Washington Lee turned their focus to crosstown rival Yorktown. The two teams squared off in front of a large and rowdy but bipartisan crowd. Just 3 minutes into the game, Spencer Brown found the back of the net to give WL an early lead. The Generals held that through the first period, but in the second, Yorktown responded with two of their own, grabbing momentum. Two more goals by the Patriots early in the third deflated the Generals. As the game winded down under 3 minutes, the Generals' fortunes looked bleak, but they found themselves on the wrong side of a 5-on-3 power play. But against the odds, the Generals kept battling, and a shorthanded goal by Ned Huffman with 2:22 remaining gave WL some life. Just 16 seconds after Huffman's goal, Ben Stanley took the puck on the attack, and after a great individual effort, split the defense. Stanley brought the crowd to their feet when he found the back of the net for another shorthanded goal, bringing the Generals to within one. Unfortunately, they were unable to come all the way back with their frantic effort. Yorktown scored a late empty netter, sealing the game, and WL fell on this rivalry night once again. When the 2015-16 edition of the Washington Lee Generals hit the ice for the first time back in October, expectations for the upcoming season were tempered. But over the first half of the year, they came together quickly and showed they could compete and beat anyone with one of the best starts in team history. While close losses in the CSHL Final Four and Yorktown leave more to be desired, they know their ultimate goals are within reach. And for the club's lone senior, Cole Praver, he leaves as one of the winningest players in club history, helping to further elevate the standard of success for future players. And now, it is my pleasure to introduce to you your 2015-16 Washington Lee Generals.
Feeling my way through the darkness, guided by a beating heart. I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start. They tell me I'm too young to understand. They say I'm caught up in a dream. Well, life will pass me by if I don't open up my eyes. So that's fine by me. So wake me up.